Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to configure incremental refresh while using a stored procedure. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam, this guy. All right, so first, what's a stored procedure? Stored procedure is a series of queries that you group together into one procedure. And they're available in a lot of relational database sources. And sometimes that's the only way people can access data from those relational database systems. And for so long, it wasn't supported until now. Before I get started, I want to give a big shout out to Sandeep, Hope Foley, and Alex Powers for kind of providing all the resources to help me lead me down the path of solving this particular problem. All right. So you all know what I like to do instead of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing I did was open up Power BI, open up the query editor, and I created the range start and range end parameters. And then I'm gonna do new source, choose SQL Server. You can choose Azure SQL, doesn't matter. Windows.net and VentureWorks. And what you wanna do is expand this out, and I'm gonna paste a valid execution of your stored procedure. So exec get internet sales, and you pass in the start and end date. And so if we head over to Management Studio, you can see this is the definition of my stored procedure. I'm accepting two parameters, start and end date, and I'm using those just like I would set up incremental refresh. I would say after or equal to this date and before that date. And so I just use this as a source for accessing my SQL Server. So I'm gonna go ahead and click OK. Here we go. And so you can see my data, click OK. And then here we go. Let me quickly rename this, step query one. Now we're gonna go into the advanced editor because you gotta write a little M. Not a ton of M, but just a little bit. So we're gonna go right here and close this off. And then what we're gonna do is say native query equals. And we're gonna use the value.native query function here. And when I open the parentheses, got a couple of different ways you can execute this. We're gonna go to the third one, and you can see it accepts a source, the query, and some parameters, and some other optional parameters. So we're gonna do this, take this, and put this way out here. Let me get my comma, there we go. So the source is our source, right? The next thing is the query that we're gonna execute, which is this query that we're gonna execute right there. Hang on. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna replace these two with the name of those parameters in the stored procedure. So at start date, at end date. This is where Sandeep's blog post came in handy because he pointed out to me that this value native query, you can actually set values for those parameters, which was really nice, right? So Hope Foley and Alex Powers actually pointed me to this blog post, amazing blog post. Something else I wanna say, right? A little asterisk. If you have access to views and the table in the relational database, you don't need to do this. Don't go through all this. I'm only showing this because this was a specific requirement for a particular custom, okay? So once you do this, then the next thing you wanna do is put a little comma, do bracket, right? And this is with those parameters, okay? So we're gonna say start date. Guess what we're gonna make start date equal? Range start. And then end date. Guess we're gonna make end date equal, range end. One of the most important parameters of this is enable folding equals true, just like that. I'm missing my brackets right here. And I'm gonna post a sample of this code in the description, right? And so you can see I'm saying, hey, we're gonna use the value native query. This is our source, so we're gonna use that. We're gonna execute this, passing these two parameters from these values, which we've assigned the range start and range into. Instead of source, we're gonna output native query. So I'm gonna go ahead and click done. There we go. So let's right click and see if it's folding. Huh, looks like it's folding. That's all right. And then we're gonna click close and apply. Is the data all loaded up? Now we right click here. Choose incremental refresh. Look at that. Turn it on. We don't get any warnings or anything. And so we're gonna do this for 2 years or three, whatever you want. Make it three, whatever. And we're gonna refresh the current year. Just like that. We configured incremental refresh like we normally do. Click apply, save it, and publish it out. Once it's saved and published out, let's go over to the stored procedure. This guy right here. We're gonna click refresh. Before we do that, in Azure Data Studio, I'm gonna launch a trace on that database because I wanna see the queries that it's pulling through. Right click, launch profiler. Profiler started up. Now let's go ahead and do our refresh. Then we're gonna sift through all the noise and see which ones are actually coming through. Starting. So now that it's complete, Let's sift through all this and see, right? Let's see, can we find, remote procedure call is what you'd be looking for. So there's one for 2020 to 2021. There's one from 2021 to 2022. See, we should have another one, 2022 to 2023. We should have one more, right? 2019 to 2020. So it's actually issuing individual calls for each partition, which was promising. I was looking at this, like, this is nice. The next thing I wanted to check was I wanted to go and see if it actually created the partitions. So back over in Management Studio, let's go over here and let's refresh this guy. I'm just connected with the XMLA endpoint because I'm in a premium capacity. This will work for pro also. So now let's go to the table, right click on it and do partitions. And what you'll see is my four partitions. They were all processed around 451. Now watch this. I'm going to leave this open. I'm going to go back over to the service and I'm going to refresh that data set one more time. And remember, it was 451. What we should see when I refresh this is only the most recent partition, the date and time, there we go, it's finished, should only change for that partition. So let's go back over to Management Studio and refresh this. Remember, we're all at 451. This one should be 452, 453. The quick refresh. There we go. 452. Only that partition refresh. What? What do you think about this? So now, if your only way for accessing your data is using a stored procedure, you can do it and you can use incremental refresh with a stored procedure. I remember Chris Webb and I came up with a hacky solution, but now this is a little more elegant. All right, what do you think? Have you run into this before? Have you solved this a different way? Are you using this method? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. It's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel. Hit that subscribe button, like my video. Big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.